So usually I try to edit how I sound or how I look and hope that I can portray this image of me to people that I have my shit together. But I don't have my shit together, and I'm finally starting to come to terms with that. To sum it up, I broke down at the end of college. I had a very stressful end of the school year, and I didn't have time to take a breath or to really look at what I wanted to do moving forward. So the day I graduated, I was extremely sad. And it was hard because there's people congratulating you, and there's your peers who are obviously so happy and proud of their accomplishments. And you know, on a factual level that you should feel the same. Like, I knew what I was supposed to feel, but I wasn't feeling that. I was super depressed. I was in a very dark place, and I didn't believe I was going to get better. My fixation on the need to get better hurt my present, because my present wasn't better. My present was bad. And I did not know how to take the little steps to get better, because every little step felt like a crumb. I think the worst part is that I'm a creative. Like, everyone's creative in their own sense, but I think I really define myself as being someone who expresses themselves visually, a lot through editing. And obviously I was not inspired at all. Like, I didn't even remember what it felt like to be passionate about making things. And I think that was one of the most heartbreaking things. I felt like I'd burned myself out so hard at the end of the year with projects, with events, with showcases, and of course with graduation, that I didn't want to revisit any of that. But I think the issue with studying what you love or working in the field of something you're passionate in is that oftentimes the more you know about something, the more you get disillusioned about it. And I think I was starting to confuse what I really wanted to do versus the external pressures that I was feeling. I was having a hard time coming to terms with this romanticized view of what a college grad was supposed to be versus my reality of, yeah, it's going to be tough. It's going to take time. I forgot how to just live in the present because I was living in the past. And also on top of all of this, I was feeling so much anxiety about the future. I just had a lot of fears when I was graduating. And a lot of those fears was losing contact with friends or people that I was so used to being around and being close with. I was definitely already, like, I was living in regret, you know, like in premeditated regret. I was still in school and I was already feeling sad about losing the people who were still around me. I don't know. I think it's a thing a lot of people go through. Like, it's just realistic when you're graduating, you start wondering, like, who are the people who are going to stay in your life? And this mix of depression and anxiety, it ruined so much of me at that time. I was predominantly at home and just wanted to isolate myself from everyone. I had some really good friends, and one in particular that really just listened to me. And I think that helped a lot. Just knowing that people weren't giving up on me and that they would give me space. But every once in a while, they would still try to let me know that they cared. I'm better now. I'm so much better now because I'm at a normal level. And I cannot express you how good it feels. Like, it feels great to not feel bad. For the longest time, I felt like something was missing from me, and I think I'm slowly finding it again. I was void of ideas and inspiration, but today is the first where I thought, like, let me make this audio recording and then it'll go from there. And that's what it is. It's just being able to not just take in the world around me, but also create the world around me. Life's not always going to be like this, but why think and worry about when it's not, when it currently is.